Subscribe to Marg Tutorial YouTube channel and press this bell icon so you can stay updated with latest videos. Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about hooks feature in Marg ERP. Using hooks option in Marg software, you can customize your Marg software by doing self-programming as per your requirement. So, let us now see its process in the software. For which, go to Masters, to Marg Setups, to Advanced Features, and then to Self-Programming Hooks. And you can see that all the options are disabled here. Now, to enable these options, that is, Hooks, you will go to Masters, then Marg Setups, then Control Room, and after entering on Search in All, you will search Hook and click on Accept. As you can see that in first option, you have to select where to do self-programming, that is in inventory, accounting or in both. To do self-programming in inventory, select 1, for accounting, select 2 and for both, select 3. Suppose, let us select 1. Now here you can view the options in which you can set where to define the hooks. Like here, it is given development hook required on header start. Header means the starting of the bill where details of the party are filled. So, if you want to define hook at the starting of the bill, then you will select yes, otherwise select no. Now suppose, let us suppose do yes. Similarly, if you want to define hook at the end of the header, means after filling the party details, then you will set yes, otherwise select no. Likewise, you will select whether to define hooks in the item part, means in the starting and at the end of the item or not. In the same way, if you want to define hooks at the footer start, means after selecting items, and at the footer end, means after saving the bill, then you will set yes or no as per your requirement. You will now press escape key and then click on yes to save the changes. Now again, go to self-programming hooks and you can view that now these options of self-programming hooks are now enabled. To define hook at the starting of the bill, go to header start and then go to commands. So in this way, you can view the default sample code which is commented. You can also uncomment to use this code or define the code as per your requirement. Suppose, let us uncomment this code. Now here, if you want to ask date, name and remark, then in this way you will define this code. You can view that variable for date is defined as myv_date and you can also define this variable as per the requirement. Here you can view marg_bill_startOn which is the predefined variable for bill start. And here startOn is shown and here startIn is shown because we are currently working on header start, that is starting of the bill. And if you go to header end, then start off is displayed. Let us now again go to header start. Now here you can view the serial numbers 0, 1, 2. Means as many variables that you define, you have to define their serial number as well. Then here you can view that the heading is also defined. That is the prompt for date, value and remark, which will open its heading will be my own heading start on. And can also change the heading as per your requirement. After this, in color fill, you can view the coordinates of prompt box, that is the margin from top, right, left and bottom and its color scheme. And in this way, you can get the values of these variables. Then this marg read function is a default function and it reads the values that you have get. Now is the last key function is defined, which is equal to 27. This function is used for escape key, that is, when the prompt opens and if you do not want to use it, then you can press escape key and it will be false return and go back. However, if the last key function is true, then the date, value and remark would trim the spaces and those values will be displayed. You must remember that you must save values in string in that sequence in which position it has been defined in the starting and you must separate it with a pipe sign. To save the code, you will press Ctrl+W. Next, here is run commands, means if you want to view the preview of the code that you have saved, then you will press enter. So you can view that the prompt is open. In this way, you can define the code for date, value and remark. Let us now understand this with an example. If you want that the bill should not be created until 10-digit mobile number is mentioned here. So, for this, you will firstly find the variable of that particular field and then press Shift plus tilde key. As we press Shift plus tilde key on mobile field, then you can view the variable of mobile field, that is INVOPHO, and now you can set command on this variable. You must note that the variable will only be displayed when hook is enabled. You will now apply this command in development hook for header end, because if this code is applied in header start, then software will not be able to check mobile number, as mobile number is after the start of header. So you will apply this command in the header end so that it checks mobile number field after header start. As we will now define the command in which firstly if there will be any spaces in left or right, then it will be trimmed and then its length will be stored in the myv_value variable. Now let us enter the condition, that is, if the myv_value is not equal to 10, then a message will be displayed, invalid mobile number. Then press Ctrl plus W to save and then generate the bill after exiting this window. Now suppose if you will generate a bill and leave the mobile number field blank and then keep pressing enter. So you can view an alert message of invalid mobile number and software has stopped the user to create the bill because the mobile field is blank and this condition has turned false. Now suppose after selecting the party, if you enter the mobile number, then you can view that you can generate the bill. Let us see another example of plywood. Like if the length of a ply is 4 meter and width is 6 meter and rate of 1 meter ply is rupees 30. So if we want that length, width and rate of 1 meter should be multiplied and that multiplied value to be multiplied with quantity and then it should be displayed in rate. For which we will press Shift plus tilde key on rate field to get the variable of rate which is displayed to you as prorate. You will apply this command in development hook for item start because item quantity comes in the starting of item. Let's come to commands and here we can view the code defined and can view that three variables are defined for length, width and rate per meter. Here you can view the headings defined, that is length, width, rate or MTR, which will be displayed in the prompt box. And here we have defined that all these three fields are numeric. Then last key function has been defined, that is if last key function is equal to 27. Then it will be false return and no value will be returned. Again, an if condition has been defined, that is, if the value of length is not 0, then the value of length and width will be multiplied and then that amount will be multiplied to rate per meter. And this value will be derived and will be displayed in mProRate, that is, in rate field. You will now press Ctrl plus W to save and then generate the bill after exiting this window. Now, when generating the bill, the user will select the item and you can view that a prompt has appeared. Suppose, enter length as 4, then enter width as 6. You will now enter the rate of 1 meter ply, suppose enter 30. You can view that the value of rate has been calculated and is displayed here as 720. Enter the quantity now and press enter and then the amount will be calculated and displayed here. Now you will save the bill. After this, as you can view that reference example for code has been given to you, like here you have been given code for display text, input text, combo selection and command button, which you can use as per your requirement in hooks. Like as we want that submit and cancel command button should also be displayed in the prompt box in this way. For which we will go to development hook for item start. You can view that we have applied the code for command button after rate per meter command as we want that submit and cancel button should be displayed after rate per meter. Now press Ctrl plus W to save and then generate the bill after exiting this window. As we will select item, you can view that command buttons are displayed in the prompt box. Then you will mention the length, width and rate per meter. So after entering the value, you can either submit it or cancel it. Like if we will click on submit, then you can view that the value is calculated and is displayed in rate. So friends, in this way you can customize your Marg software by doing self-programming as per your requirement. Thanks for watching.